Welcome to another video. Finally, some good news today. Dexamethasone is now being called a major breakthrough based on a recent randomized controlled trial in the UK. Let's discuss. Dexamethasone, also known as Decadron, is an example of a glucocorticoid. Glucocorticoids are sometimes referred to as corticosteroids. Other examples of glucocorticoids include hydrocortisone, methylprednisolone, prednisone, Betamethasone, and triamcinolone. So glucocorticoids are a class of steroid hormones that bind to the glucocorticoid receptor in the body. Cortisol, aka hydrocortisone, is the glucocorticoid we naturally make in our body. It's essential for life. It regulates or supports various cardiovascular, metabolic, and homeostatic functions. It also plays a big role in our immune system, especially when it comes to reducing certain aspects of inflammation. This is why we use them all the time in medicine. We sometimes give these steroids for asthma, COPD, rheumatologic type diseases, and countless more diseases. Sometimes we give steroids for meningitis and also for some forms of cancer. We also give them in the early course of severe ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome. Whether that ARDS is due to infection, such as pneumonia, or vaping lung injury, or whatever the cause. For severe ARDS, we typically give methylprednisolone, aka solumedrol, at a dose of 1 milligram per kilogram per day. So for most people, that ends up being around 80 milligrams per day. So this is the equivalent of 15 milligrams of dexamethasone. The idea here is to suppress the cytokine storm that has taken place, meaning that the massive amount of inflammation that causes lung damage and can indirectly cause damage to other organs as well. Our body naturally makes cortisol in our adrenal glands, specifically in the zona fasciculata of the adrenal cortex. The adrenal gland then secretes cortisol into the bloodstream, and the cortisol travels to different tissues of the body and then binds to the glucocorticoid receptor inside cells. It then stimulates the cell to make more anti-inflammatory proteins and causes the cell to make less pro-inflammatory proteins. But giving someone glucocorticoids, meaning steroids, to someone who has an infection is somewhat of a tricky thing because the fear is that if you suppress the body's immune system, it has the potential to make the infection worse. But sometimes the body's immune system does more damage than the actual infection. For example, in cases of meningitis that is due to either streptococcus or tuberculosis, we give steroids because the medical evidence shows that they have better outcomes when we do so. And giving someone steroids for viral pneumonias like influenza is more controversial because doing so generally leads to worse infection. With that said, if the viral pneumonia is so bad to the point of causing severe ARDS, most doctors, including myself, will give steroids in that situation. So this is why the general medical guidelines so far recommend against giving steroids for COVID pneumonia unless the patient has severe ARDS. And we've been waiting for randomized controlled trials to come out for steroids in COVID, and here we are now with this study. So in March of 2020, the RECOVERY trial, which stands for Randomized Evaluation of COVID-19 Therapy, was one of the randomized controlled trials that actually looked at several different potential treatments for COVID, which included low-dose dexamethasone. This trial was done in the UK and had over 11,500 patients in it. So this trial has not been peer-reviewed as of the making of this video and has not been published in the journal yet. So everything I know so far is based on what's been released to the general public. In this trial, over 2,100 patients were randomized to receive dexamethasone, specifically 6 milligrams once per day for 10 days. And this group was compared with over 4,300 patients that were randomized to the standard care alone. So 6 milligrams of dexamethasone is the equivalent of 32 milligrams of methylprednisolone. So this is about half the dose we would typically use for someone with severe ARDS. So among the patients who received standard care alone, 28-day mortality was highest in those who required mechanical ventilation. This was 41%. And then intermediate in those patients who required supplemental oxygen only. This was mortality rate of 25%. And the mortality rate was lowest among those who did not require supplemental oxygen, in which that mortality rate was 13%. For patients who were on mechanical ventilators, dexamethasone reduced mortality from 41% to 28%. For patients who needed supplemental oxygen, it reduced mortality from 25% to 20%. And there was no benefit among those patients who do not require supplemental oxygen. In other words, if someone only had mild disease, there was no point in giving dexamethasone. So based on these results, one death would be prevented by the treatment of around 8 ventilated patients. So that's the number needed to treat for ventilated patients. And then the number needed to treat for the ones who required supplemental oxygen, that number needed to treat would be 25. So these preliminary results are significant, but it doesn't mean that dexamethasone is a miracle drug. It's certainly not a cure, but it does seem to help based on these numbers. And dexamethasone could be of huge benefit in not just rich countries, but poorer countries as well, because this drug is very cheap and is widely available. So this is great news and very exciting, but there are still a lot of questions that need to be answered, like what is the ideal dose? Should we use higher doses in patients who are mechanically ventilated with ARDS? And when will it be approved for use in the United States? And we'll get these answers pretty soon. Now, another interesting question is, should we give Decadron, dexamethasone, to people who have mild disease? Now, even though this study didn't show any benefit, the reason why I bring this up is because some people start out with mild disease and then go on to have moderate or severe disease. And we have no way of predicting who goes on to do that. And also, it happens very quickly, lots of times. Someone could be doing just fine, and then all of a sudden, within hours, they all of a sudden are deteriorating and they have severe disease. So should we give those patients Decadron regardless? Is there any harm doing so? That's another question that remains to be seen. So hopefully we get some more answers. With that said, I'm very happy that we have some good news finally, and we'll see what happens going from here on out. So that's all I have for this video. If you have questions, you can hit me up on my Instagram. And also don't forget to hit that bell button to get notified of my next video, and subscribe if you haven't already. See you in the next one.